This is a video response to Intrigue 1987 and the discussion we've been having on determinism. I just pretty much, after I watched your videos, I went and made some notes, so I may jump around a little bit here. First thing I want to talk about is the micro versus macro. Now, I understand where you're coming from in terms of saying that a virus could be considered macro, and it all boils down to definitions here. I mean, what are we? Let me put it this way: when we initially started talking about micro versus macro in terms of the double slit experiment, we were talking about quantum mechanics, and when I took it from that perspective. By micro, I'm meaning the subatomic particles. So yes, I mean, you know, giving some leeway with the definitions, you could say that a virus is micro. But in terms of what I'm talking about when I say micro, I'm talking about subatomic particles. And, you know, I mean, obviously, like I said, with the definitions, you can draw a line between what you think micro is and macro. But just to be clear, when I'm talking about micro, I'm talking about subatomic particles. And from that perspective, I don't see any evidence, any experiments that can prove that the micro, in terms of quantum mechanics, has any effect on the macro world. And you talked about the double slit experiment again, and just how, you said by observing the experiment, it changed the outcome. Now, it wasn't by observing it that it changed the outcome, but it was when they inserted a device into the mechanism that made the outcome different. I think a lot of times when people use the double slit experiment as an example, they kind of give they're a little bit generous with the definition of observe, and a lot of times you can give the impression that, well, if you just look at the experiment, then it will change the outcome. But that's not really what happens. The actual physical device in the experiment is what caused the change. I mean, honestly, I don't really understand the details of the physics behind it, but it was the device itself that caused the change. It was a physical interaction. It wasn't like, you know, if they ran the experiment at one point and somebody's back was turned, it went one way, but if they looked at it, it went differently. It was the actual insertion of the physical object in the experiment that caused this change. It doesn't lead to a new paradigm, you know, by saying that because they inserted a device into it that this changed the experiment. I mean, this is still the macro affecting the micro. as far as my, you know, this was in your questions video, my definition of determinism, and I think what you laid out pretty much says what my feelings are about determinism and what it actually means. It's a chain reaction, basically. From the beginning of the universe till now, everything has been determined to be what it is. And I think this kind of plays into what I'm talking about in terms of choices. And I know you'd asked me about what it means to make a choice and my reasons for unpacking, you know, the human body and the brain into its most fundamental particles. I think it all has to do with abstraction. I mean, you can't understand a system without understanding its individual parts. Let's say, if I just say the game of baseball, if someone doesn't know what the individual parts or the individual say, the rules of baseball. If you don't understand what those things are, then you won't understand what I'm talking about. So by unpacking the entire, I guess you'd call it, system of the human body, breaking the muscles down all the way down to the cells, to the molecular level, and doing the same thing to the brain and trying to understand it from its individual particles, I think it's the only way that you can get a real grasp on what you're talking about. I mean, even if you just say the brain, if you don't have any information in addition to that, if you don't know anything about the parts of the brain, then you won't understand what the person is talking about. And it's a level of abstraction that you need to kind of dig into in order to understand what the brain is. I mean, just using the word brain, it implies an entire list of additional factors that you have to take into account. Well, what is the brain? And with each additional level, you can say neurons, and then you can ask the question again, what is a neuron? And until you get down to the most fundamental parts of what the entire system is made of, you cannot really make an assessment of, you know, what's going on in this system. Like, you know, you use the example as, well, you referred to my example of going for a walk. Somebody making a decision to go for a walk, that system has to be broken down if you want to understand it in a deterministic way. To just say going for a walk, what does that imply? I mean, you'd almost have to assume ignorance to say, okay, well, what does it mean to go for a walk? Well, it means one leg moves in front of the other. And you can ask the same question, what does that mean to move one leg in front of the other, and break it down into its most fundamental parts.